How much energy will be needed to power AI? That's the question we set out to answer recently. We analysed brand new data sets and consulted extensively with the tech sector, the energy industry, policymakers, and international experts. Most of AI's energy needs are concentrated in data centres. And inside each data centre are any number of servers which create immense amounts of heat as they process data. Running those servers and keeping them cool is one of the main drivers of electricity consumption for AI. To give you an idea of how much electricity these data centres use, today, a hyperscale data centre operated by a big tech company uses about as much electricity as 100,000 households. The largest data centre currently under development will use 20 times that amount. Global investment in data centres has nearly doubled since 2022, and in 2024, it amounted to $500 billion. That boom in investment has led to growing concerns about the possibility of skyrocketing electricity demand to power these data centres. On a global scale, data centres accounted for about 1.5% of electricity consumption in 2024. By 2030, electricity consumption by data centres is set to roughly double to about 3% of global consumption. That means data centres will be consuming around 945 terawatt hours a year. And to put that into context, that's about as much as the entire yearly electricity consumption of Japan today. The processing needs of AI will be the most significant driver of this increase in data center electricity consumption. Regardless of where you're interacting with AI, it's highly likely that the data will be routed through one of a few clusters of data centers. They're dotted all around the globe, but a few markets are dominant today. The United States accounted for 45% of data center electricity consumption in 2024, followed by 25% in China and 15% in Europe. Over the next 10 years, we see new data centers in the pipeline all over the world, but some countries are set to see more growth than others, which could have big effects on their electricity systems. In the US, data centers are on course to account for almost half of the overall growth in electricity demand between now and 2030. Interestingly, the US economy is set to consume more electricity in 2030 for processing data than producing all aluminium, steel, cement, and chemicals combined. And it's not the only region where the effects could be pronounced. In Japan, data centers could account for more than half of demand growth. And in Malaysia, it could be as much as one-fifth. Electricity grids are already under strain in many places, and we estimate that around 20% of planned data center projects could be at risk of delays if these strains aren't addressed. We've also found that 50% of data centers under development in the United States, for example, are in places where there are already large clusters of other data centers, which could risk strains on local grids and holdups to them coming online. These problems could be replicated in other places where there are data center clusters around the world. Natural gas and renewables take the lead in powering data centers. Natural gas can provide baseload power in places where it is cheap and abundant, notably the United States and the Middle East. Renewables are cost-effective, quick to build, and supported by many countries and companies. In the next decade, we also see the tech sector helping to bring forward new nuclear and geothermal technologies as well, such as small modular nuclear reactors. There are significant uncertainties that remain, but our analysis makes it very clear that because of AI, the energy and tech sectors are now on a journey together. The IEA will continue to analyze what this means for the future of energy, and we'll be back with more videos exploring key findings from this report very soon.